So intriguing. We head into round number six. There have been three major low blows landed. Two by Vargas, one by Tyner. We've had action at the end of each round, right near the bell, and had some punches after the round ended. And for the most part, it's been a very active fight for Jessie Vargas, with him out punching Tyner in terms of numbers.
And it's up to Tyner to bring the heat. Vargas is going to be very happy to suck into his left and pump that jab.
Tyner, the 36-year-old from Detroit, now using his own jab. It's kind of an effective punch, and he made the point to us yesterday. Everyone says, I have a good jab, I just don't use it enough.
Well, you love to see a small, short fighter use the jab. We always think of Mike Tyson, where he would fight a 6'4" guy on a jab. Tyson does have a good jab, but I hate to tell you, he's not going to win this fight with a jab.
No, unless he uses it to get on the inside.
Right.
Emil Griffin, for sure, is a welterweight. I mentioned Gil Pansy earlier, friend Emil Griffin. Emil had a good jab. It's about time more than anything else. Halfway through round number six, and Vargas has kept this round completely long range. And Tyner has allowed him to do that, which might not be the best tactical move for him.
Now, Tyner fights and stops. And that's one of his problems.
Stop.
He relaxes in front of you and let you work. Right now, he's coming forward, but he hasn't really landed anything of note other than a few jabs this night.
Jessie Vargas at 22 lands a nice right hand. Says he does not consider himself a prospect. He considers himself a contender. Leonard Elvin, of course, Mayweather Promotions and the manager of Floyd Mayweather Jr. told us they think that within this calendar year they can get Vargas in a major fight.
Answer.
Right now is a fight with Lanardo Tyner. It's a rough and tumble one. The right hand by Vargas. Tyner comes with the right and does some jawing at Jessie Vargas. He's winning the debate, Lanardo Tyner.
He is. And the Mayweathers are all over this fight. Of course, Floyd's company is promoting it. Roger, who's seen it over to our left, used to train Vargas. And Jeff, who's Roger's brother, excuse me, we saw in the first fight with Lanardo. We just missed the old man. Where is he?
Yeah, he's late. Center is not here today. Second two men here in round six. Around the Vargas kind of controls to the outside. Again, here they go, wailing away. They will not be having cocktails together later.
Just like this last round. Keep doing the same thing.
Come back with your hook. You know what I'm saying? Then go to the right, start doing right body shot to the outside. And come up with your hook on the other side. All I want is, look at, wide right hand, left hook. And jab. That pop jab won't even do. He ain't got an answer for that pop jab. Do the pop jab, that pop jab.
We head into the seventh round of the scheduled 10-rounder. Jessie Vargas in the white trunks with the red and blue stripe. 22-year-old now from Las Vegas versus California. Undefeated 17-0. Lanardo Tyner, Detroit resident. 36-year-old veteran who comes in here with a 25-6-2 record. Now, Tyner only has 15 KOs. And you point out, Steve, he's not a big power puncher. But he is probably going to need at least a knockdown or something powerful in these remaining rounds to win this fight.
Yeah, I agree 100%. I don't know that he's won a round. And in terms of going the distance, seven or more, you see what kind of veteran Tyner is. In this day and age, by today's standard, 16 is a lot. And Vargas, due to it, no KOs. I don't think Vargas is going to get a KO tonight because Tyner's never been down four stops.
Tyner has not been hurt in this fight, even though Vargas has landed some good power punches. And Vargas following the instructions of Robert Alcazar, jab,
this a boxing match. And Lanardo Tyner follows.